Hello everyone, and welcome to a week of Linux news for the 26th of February, 2017. I've nearly finished my latest round of renovating work on my house, so that'll leave just two rooms to finish. At least now I'll have more time to get back on the computer and make some videos. Another old vulnerability has been dug up in the Linux kernel again. This time it's a vulnerability with the IPv6 implementation of the Datagram Congestion Control Protocol, or DCCP for short. There is a long explanation of DCCP on Wikipedia, but the basics of it are it deals with congestion control on the network interface. The vulnerability has likely been around since Linux kernel 2.6.14 from October 2005, which was the first version to support DCCP. This is a local exploit only and not exploitable over the internet. The vulnerability, which has been designated the Common Vulnerability Exploit Identifier of CVE-2017-6074, can allow a local user to obtain root privileges or cause a denial of service via an application that makes an IPv6 receive packet info set sock opt system call. But good news, everyone! The vulnerability has already been fixed, and it's likely your distribution has provided you an updated kernel. Just apply the updates at your convenience. There is no need to rush off now and get them done. What about the news regarding the updates this month in that other operating system? You know, that OS that shouldn't really be discussed in this video. Well, Microsoft withheld the monthly updates for February, which would have patched vulnerabilities in SMB network communication and bundled flash updates for Internet Explorer. Both those vulnerabilities are being actively exploited right now over remote attacks. In comparison, an old vulnerability that sat around for years in the kernel without anyone knowing about it doesn't seem so bad. Ubuntu 17.04 Zesty Zappos has reached Beta 1 milestone. I can't see anything much in the wiki as to what the main changes are with Ubuntu, so I will actually have to install and take a look. There is some information regarding the changes for the derivatives. Kubuntu will be getting the Plasma 5.9 desktop with KDE applications 16.12.1. It looks like they're using the Plasma 5.9.0 desktop. KDE Neon and no doubt Arch and Gentoo and any other rolling release KDE distros are already on the Plasma 5.9.2. Maybe they will change near a final release. Well, Ubuntu GNOME proudly features the GNOME 3.24 beta, and GNOME 3.24 introduces night light, which can automatically reduce the blue light emitted by your computer screen at sunset or whenever you choose. Huh, okay, I can't say that's ever something I've thought of as a problem with computers. Ubuntu Budgie appears to still be progressing forward, ready for their first formal release as an official derivative of Ubuntu. Softpedia reports that Lubuntu once again have delayed moving to the new LXQt desktop. Having reviewed the LXQt desktop in December, I don't blame them. While the desktop itself is functional, not all the LXQt specific applications have been completed, and they are falling back to using the older GTK-based LXDE apps. I suspect it could be easy enough for Lubuntu to move to LXQt, however the ISO file will have to be made larger in order to handle the mixed GTK and Qt dependencies. Lubuntu developers announced on Twitter that things didn't go as initially planned. We're behind schedule on LXQt images for 17.04, therefore we will not release LXQt images for 17.04. LXQt version 0.11.1 is included in the Ubuntu repositories, and installing it is as easy as sudo apt install LXQt. Once all the packages have been installed, log out of your current LXDE session or whatever desktop you're using, and choose LXQt from the login screen. Be warned that Lubuntu and LXQt are in beta stage of development, and are not necessarily ready for a production system. There have been two release updates for the KDE desktop recently, we have Plasma 5.9.2, which is mostly a bug fix release. A few notable updates include KWin, avoid a crash on KWin Decoration KCM teardown. The Discover software installer, make sure we don't show warnings unless it's absolutely necessary. Hey, I like the sound of that commit. Sit there and keep quiet, Discover. There are some improvements to the look and feel of Oxygen theme, and also a few bug fixes on Plasma Desktop, add-ons, and GTK config. There has also been an update to the long-term support of Plasma Desktop 5.8. My understanding is the 5.8 branch is only receiving security fixes, as the main focus of development is now on the 5.9 branch. However, looking through the changelog, there is a lot more than security fixes. We also have translation updates, bug fixes, as well as security fixes. I can't really complain that the KDE developers are continuing to improve the usability of an older desktop. LibreELEC version 8.0, Krypton, has been released, and it uses the latest version of KDE Media Player version 17. I've done a review of KDE 17, which comes with a whole new look and feel compared to previous versions. I still haven't moved to using KDE 7 yet on my home theater PC, due to lack of time. LibreELEC offers a full-blown operating system for KDE and is compatible with different hardware from x86-64 down to Raspberry Pi and other ARM-based systems. It was originally forked from OpenELEC, and it appears that they've beaten their predecessor in moving to KDE 17. And finally, some amusing news for the week. A hacker calling themselves ProMaster managed to deface a server associated with Trump's presidential campaign fundraising. The server secure2.donaldjtrump is behind Cloudflare's content management security platform and does not appear to be directly linked from the Trump-Pence campaign homepage. But it does appear to be an actual Trump campaign server. Its certificate is legitimate, but a reference to an image on another site is insecure, prompting a warning on Chrome and Firefox that the connection is not secure. Better luck next time with that cybersecurity. And that concludes the week of Linux news. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all later.